Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this video, we will be talking about the potential effects of aging on bone tissue, as well as a very pertinent clinical connection for this session, which is osteoporosis. So we have a lot of interesting things to discuss here. As mentioned, aging and osteoporosis, but also the effects of exercise on bone. I hope as you have been viewing these videos, you always come back to these learning objective slides and try to answer these questions on your own, or more importantly, in your own words. If you can do that, then you are in such excellent shape for your assessments. So if you haven't yet started doing it, get on it, and I promise this will be time well spent in terms of your studying for this course. All right. So, during the time frame of birth to approximately adolescence, more bone tissue is produced than is lost during those natural processes of bone remodeling or bone formation. In younger adults, the rate of bone resorption and deposition kind of even out, and so they're around the same. However, with increasing age, the rates change due to numerous factors, one of which being a decrease in the levels of sex hormones, and osteoclast activity can really begin to outpace osteoblasts. So this leads to two main effects on osseous tissue with aging adults. The first is going to be loss of bone mass, which occurs because of demineralization, or the loss of those appropriate calcium levels or other minerals from the bony extracellular matrix. And this can start to occur as early as 30 in certain individuals, particularly women. Another major effect of aging is the increase of brittleness in bone due to slowing of collagen production. Recall that collagen is the organic material in the extracellular matrix and is very important in terms of tensile strength. So with the loss of tensile strength, bones will become brittle and more likely to fracture and sometimes even shatter. So all of this sounds no good, right? And let's further explore the loss of bone through a specific condition. Now, osteopenia will equal low bone mass, so lower than what you would have in a healthy bone. So this osteopenia will put an individual at an increased risk of osteoporosis. And so osteoporosis is just a condition of overly porous bone or more extreme low bone mass. So you can see in a normal bone you have these trabeculae, and of course between the trabeculae you have spaces. But in an osteoporotic bone, those spaces will increase and the trabeculae will decrease in terms of size. So this increase of space is going to have a lot of implications in terms of fracture, etc. Now, simply put, an individual with osteoporosis, that bone resorption, so that bone breakdown, will occur at a much faster pace than bone deposition. And this is often due to the depletion of calcium in the body, with calcium being lost too quickly, sometimes through urine or sweat, than what is taken in by diet. Now, osteoporosis can affect the entire skeleton, but certain bones are more likely to fracture due to higher concentrations of spongy bone, such as the vertebrae, carpal bones, the ends of the femur, particularly that proximal end of the femur. And with severe osteoporosis, you can sometimes see what is referred to as shrinkage of the vertebrae, causing increased curvature. And this, what's really happening here is you have all these mini fractures occurring in the bodies of the vertebrae. So these are the bodies of the vertebrae. These are almost completely composed of spongy bone, except for a layer of compact bone. So you'll have a fracture or multiple fractures within that spongy bone, leading to a mini collapse of these bones, which will increase the curvature and can actually lead to height loss with time. Another main thing to consider and it could be because of many fractures, is that one of the main symptoms of osteoporosis is going to be bone pain. Osteoporosis mainly affects individuals that are middle-aged or of advanced age, and there is also a higher incidence rate in women than men, and this is due to one of two factors. Women's bones tend to, but certainly are not always, but they tend to be smaller than men's, so more likely to have greater effects with bone loss on these smaller bones, or comparatively smaller bones. Additionally, estrogen production tends to slow with earlier ages than testosterone, and we know that sex hormones will initiate osteoblast activity. But I want to note that there are other risk factors, such as family history, so a family history of osteoporosis, certain ancestries, such as European or Asian ancestries, small body builds just in general, so a male or any individual with a smaller body build will just have a higher incidence of or a risk factor for osteoporosis. Inactive lifestyles, this is a big one as well. Smoking, just to name a few of the risk factors. Now, knowing what you know regarding the mechanisms that lead to osteoporosis and what causes osteoporosis, what are some areas that you can address in order to treat osteoporosis? So what are some potential ways? Think of what you can do or what you can speed up or what you can slow down in order to treat osteoporosis. So you can pause the video and just kind of brainstorm. And I'm not talking about telling me any specific type of drugs, but think about what type of cells you could speed up or slow down. And I like to break it down in kind of that way. So slowing down bone loss or increasing bone building. So either one of these, the slowing down of bone loss or the increasing of osteoblast activity, this can be done through medicines, so anti-reabsorptive drugs and or bone-building drugs that can help inhibit osteoclasts or increase osteoblast activity. And I'm not really going to get into the specific names or types of these drugs here, but there is certainly a plethora that are used for these purposes. Additionally, carefully and safely incorporating weight-bearing exercise can initiate osteoblasts as well. So, that stress and strain that weight-bearing exercise puts on bone tissue will often initiate that deposition of minerals and production of collagen through the osteoblasts. So, those main mechanical stresses on bone result from the pull of muscles when they contract, specifically the skeletal muscle, because those are the ones that are attaching to bone, as well as the pull of good old gravity. So people of all ages can and should strengthen their bones by engaging in weight-bearing exercise, with, of course, considering any underlying conditions and making sure you're safe to do so under a physician's recommendation. I am not a physician, so make sure to, you know, while I can talk about the mechanisms that can occur with osteoblast activity increasing with exercise, you always want to make sure that it's safe to do so on an individual level. Now, before we finish, let's make sure we understand a basic concept from this video. So, true or false, bone deposition occurs at a faster rate than resorption or bone resorption in an individual with osteoporosis. So pause the video if you want to think it through, but when you are ready, let's discuss how false is the correct answer here. It is actually bone resorption that is going to occur at a faster rate than bone deposition when you're talking about an individual with osteoporosis. So that is a core concept here. If you have missed this, I would make sure to review this again, and please reach out to me with any questions. Thank you for your time and attention here, and have a great day.